On June 15, 2005, and it came into force on October 12, 2005. This RTI Act was enacted to provide for setting out the practical regime of right to information for citizens in the country to secure access to information under the control of public authorities in order to promote accountability and transparency in the working of each public authority. The RTI Act of 2005 replaces the earlier Freedom of Information Act of 2002. Under the provisions of the RTI Act 2005, any individual in the country may request for information from a public authority, and the authority is required to provide information to the RTI applicant within a stipulated period. This act covers all constitutional institutions, authorities, including the executive, legislature and judiciary, and any institution or organization or any body established or constituted by the Act of Parliament or a state legislature. It also covers institution that is directly or indirectly owned, controlled or substantially funded by the government. Private organizations will not come under the RTI Act, but private institutions and NGOs, non-governmental organizations who receive over 95% of their infrastructure funds from the government will come under the RTI Act. The Central Information Commission held that the political parties are public authorities and are answerable to the citizens under the RTI Act. The CIC said that six national parties, Congress, BJP, NCP, CPIM, CPI and BSP and BJD, has been substantially funded indirectly by the central government and have the character of public authorities under the RTI Act as they perform public functions. But in August 2013, the government introduced a Right to Information Amendment Bill which would remove political parties from the scope of the RTI Act. Currently, no parties are under the RTI Act, and there has a case been filed for bringing up all political parties under the RTI Act. The Supreme Court of India on 13th November 2019 upheld the decision of Delhi High Court bringing the Office of Chief Justice of India under the purview of RTI Act. The right to information in India is governed by two major bodies that are Central Information Commission and State Information Commission. The Central Information Commission is headed by Chief Information Commissioner, who heads all the central departments and ministries with their own public information officers. The CICs are directly under the President of India. The State Information Commission is headed by the State Chief Information Commissioner, and there are not more than 10 information commissioners. They are appointed by the governor of the state. State and Central Information Commissions are independent bodies, and Central Information Commission has no jurisdiction over the State Information Commission. The Central Information Commission was constituted with effect from October 12, 2005 under the provisions of Right to Information Act 2005. The Central Information Commission covers all central public authorities. The Central Information Commission is headed by Chief Information Commissioner. The Central Information Commission will consist of the Chief Information Commissioner and Central Information Commissioners. They are not exceeding more than 10 members. The Chief Information Commissioner and Information Commissioners shall be appointed by the President of India on the recommendation of a committee which consists of the Prime Minister, who shall act as the chairperson of the committee, the leader of opposition in the Lok Sabha, a union cabinet minister to be nominated by the Prime Minister of India. The Chief Information Commissioner, who will be assisted by the Information Commissioners in supervision, direction and management of the affairs of the Central Information Commission, which are vested under the RTI Act. The Chief Information Commissioner and Information Commissioners are to be persons of eminence in public life with wide knowledge and experience in the field of law, science, technology, social service, management, journalism, mass media or administration and governance. The Chief Information Commissioner or an Information Commissioner shall not be a member of Parliament or member of state legislature of any state or union territory, as the case may be, or hold any other office of profit or connected with any political party or carrying on any business or pursuing any profession. The RTI Act 2005 mandates that the Central Information Commissioner and State Information Commissioner will serve for 5-year term. With the amendment, the term of the CIC shall be notified by the central government. The Chief Information Commissioner or an Information Commissioner may at any time, by writing under his hand, address to the President, may resign from his office. The President may suspend the Chief Information Commissioner or Information Commissioner if necessary and prohibit them from attending the office during the inquiry against him. The Chief Information Commissioner or any Information Commissioner shall be removed from his office only by the order of President. Every state government of India, by notification in the Official Gazette, shall constitute the State Information Commission to exercise the powers conferred on and to perform the functions assigned to it under the RTI Act of 2005. The State Information Commission shall consist of the State Chief Information Commissioner and State Information Commissioners, not exceeding 10. The State Chief Information Commissioner and the State Information Commissioners shall be appointed by the Governor of the State on the recommendation of a committee which consists of the Chief Minister, who will act as the chairperson of the committee, the Leader of Opposition in Legislative Assembly and a Cabinet Minister to be nominated by the Chief Minister. The General Superintendent's direction and management of the affairs of the State Information Commission shall vest in the State Chief Information Commissioner, who will be assisted by the State Information Commissioners. The State Chief Information Commissioner hold office for a term specified by the government. He will not be eligible for reappointment, provided that no State Chief Information Commissioner shall hold office after he has attained the age of 65 years. The State Information Commissioner may hold office till he attains 65 years of age and he is eligible for appointment as Chief Information Commissioner. The State Chief Information Commissioner or a State Information Commissioner may resign from his office at any time by writing under his hand addressed to the Governor. The State Chief Information Commissioner or a State Information Commissioner shall be removed from his office only by the order of Governor of the concerned state. If it is necessary, the Governor of the concerned state may suspend the State Chief Information Commissioner or a State Information Commissioner from office. The process of RTI begins with making an RTI application for seeking information by an applicant, and it ends with providing information to the RTI applicant by the concerned public authorities. According to the provisions of RTI Act, Each authority which is covered under the RTI Act has to appoint their public information officers, and any person may write a request to the public information officer for information. Any individual may submit a request seeking information to the public information officer, and it is the responsibility of the public information officer to provide information to the RTI applicant. When the RTI request relates to another public authority completely or partially, then it is the duty of the public information officer to transfer or forward the information request to the concerned public information officer of the other authority within 5 working days. In addition to this, each authority is required to appoint assistant public information officers to receive RTI requests and appeals and forwarding them to the public information officer of their public authority. An individual person who wishes to seek information from a public authority is required to send the application along with a demand draft, banker check, or a postal order of 10 rupees payable to the accounts officer of the concerned public authority as a fee to obtain information under the RTI Act. If it is necessary, the applicant may also be required to pay further fee towards the fee for obtaining information from the concerned public authority. There is no fee required to be paid towards the application fee if a person belongs to the below the poverty line as per the RTI rules. While filing the RTI request, the applicant has to disclose his name and contact details. There is no necessary for the RTI applicant to provide details or defense for seeking information under the RTI Act. The Central Information Commission receives the complaints from the individuals where the individuals are not able to submit their information requests to the public information officer or state public information officer as the respective PIO not having been appointed, or because of the central assistant PIO or state assistant PIO refused to receive the RTI application from the individuals. If the request has been made to the public information officer, the reply is to be given within 30 days from the date of receipt of application. If the request has been made to the assistant public information officer, the reply is to be given within 35 days from the date of the receipt of RTI application. If the PIO transfers the information request to another public authority, the time allowed is to reply is 30 days, but calculated from the day after it is been received by the PIO of the transferee authority. Information regarding corruption and human rights violations by scheduled security agencies, etc., is to be provided within 45 days, but with the proper approval of the Central Information Commission. If life or liberty of any person is involved, the public information officer has to reply within 48 hours. If a person who does not receive information under the RTI from the concerned public information officer, then the applicant may appeal to the next rank senior officer. After the expiry of 90 days period, the applicant, if not received any information from the concerned public authority, then he or she may make a complaint with the Central Information Officer or State Public Information Officer. The Central Public Information Officer or State Public Information Officer will hear arguments of both the parties and finalize the case, or asks the concerned public information officer to provide information to the applicant within a stipulated period, or impose penalty on it. The following information is exempted from disclosing under the Section 8 of the Right to Information Act. The disclosure of information which would prejudicially affect the sovereignty and integrity of the country the security, scientific, strategic or economic interest of the state, relation with foreign state or anything which leads to incitement of an offense. The disclosure of information which has been specifically prohibited to be published by any tribunal or court of law, or the disclosure of the information which may constitute contempt of court. The disclosure of information which would cause a breach of privilege of the state legislature or parliament. The information including trade secrets, commercial confidence, intellectual property. The disclosure of information which would harm the competitive position of any third party, unless the competent authority is satisfied that larger public interest permits the disclosure of such information. Information which is available to a person in his or her fiduciary relationship, unless the competent authority is satisfied that the larger public interest warrants the disclosure of such information. Information that is received in confidence from a foreign government or state. The disclosure of information which would threaten the life or physical safety of any individual, or identify the source of information or assistance given in confidence for law enforcement or security purposes. Information which would hinder the process of investigation or apprehension or prosecution of offenders. Information relating to cabinet papers, including records of deliberations of the Council of Ministers, secretaries and other officers. Disclosure of information which relates to personal information, the disclosure of which has no relationship to any public activity or interest, or which would unnecessarily invade privacy of an individual. Central intelligence and security agencies are excluded but not absolute from providing information to RTI applicants. However, these organizations have a responsibility to provide information relating to allegations of human rights violations and corruption, but only with the approval of the Central or State Information Commission. Definition of information under Right to Information Act. Information means any material in any form, including records, documents, memos, emails, opinions, advices, press releases, circulars, orders, logbooks, contracts, reports, papers, samples, models, data material held in any electronic form, and information relating to any private body which can be accessed by a public authority under any other law for the time being in force. Right to information means the right to information accessible under this Right to Information Act, which is held by or under the control of any public authority and includes the right to inspection of work, documents, records, taking notes, extracts or certified copies of documents or records, taking certified samples of material. Obtaining information in the form of diskettes, floppies, tapes, video cassettes or in any other electronic mode, or through printouts where such information is stored in a computer or in any other device. Where the Central Information Commission or the State Information Commission, while deciding any complaint, finds that without any reasonable cause, a public authority refused to receive an application for information or has not furnished information within the time specified under the Right to Information Act, or denied the request for information, or knowingly given incorrect, incomplete or misleading information, or destroyed information which was the subject of the request, or obstructed in any manner in furnishing the information, A penalty of 250 rupees is imposed per each day till the RTI applicant receives the information or the information is furnished. However, the total amount of such penalty shall not exceed rupees 25,000.